cell culture,
a cornerstone of biological research. This technique involves growing cells under controlled conditions outside their natural environment, and the technique has revolutionized various scientific fields from basic biology to applied medical research. There are lots of different calculations you may need when doing cell culture, and if I was to run through all of them, you'd probably faint and think, this is too much. But we're just going to take it bite-sized. So the first one, we're going to look at how we count cells in order to determine the number of cells per unit volume using either hemocytometer or an automated cell counter. In counting cells or calculating cell numbers, there are some definitions to watch out for. When we say cell number versus cell concentration, that these are two different things. The number of cells is referring to how many cells there are. For example, 15 cells, that's a number. In contrast, a concentration refers to the number of cells in a given volume or area. Say 15 cells in 1 mL. If you are using an automated cell counter, it will typically give you a concentration readout. For example, 3 × 10⁶ cells per mL. Once you obtain this concentration, you would usually want to know the number of cells you have in total. Answering this question of the total number of cells comes from the concentration you have multiplied by the total volume of cells you have. So let's say the cell counter told you or reported that you have 3 × 10⁶ cells in every mil. However, you culture the cells in a 10 mil flask or culture dish. This would mean that you have 3 × 10⁶ cells times the 10 mils, the total volume that you have. And so that gives you 30 million cells. Or 3 × 10⁷ in scientific notation. By the way, my software decided to have a little fun with the scientific notation in the following presentation. Six is meant to be 10⁶. Or 10⁶, so thanks for bearing with me. When you prepare cells for counting, not all the cells will be alive. This is referred to as cell viability. So in your routine counting, you will take note of the percent viable cells. When using an automated cell counter, this tends to be quite common in most labs now, the concentration of cells that you are giving would have already factored in only the viable cells. But if you're counting manually via hemocytometer, then you would need to make sure that you are counting only viable cells. Briefly, because this video is not about the process of counting, but just in case, this would involve you adding a cell staining reagent such as trypan blue, and then when you're counting, you ignore all the cells that are stained blue. These blue cells are dead. Another common calculation is, how do we get a certain number of cells to culture? Referred to as subculturing or passaging. For example, if I want to take 20,000 cells from my 3 million cells in a flask to subculture into a new flask, how much volume of this existing cell suspension, this 3 million cell suspension, do I take? Okay, so please be aware that this is not asking for concentration, that is cells per given volume. It's just simply asking for total cells, 20,000 cells. So we know that we have 3 million cells per mil, but we want 20,000 cells in the new culture vessel. What we need to do then is divide the 20,000 cells that we want by the 3 million cells that we have. The 3 million cells per mil that we have. So 20,000 cells that we want divided by the 3 million cells per mil that we have gives us 0.0066 mil, which is a tiny volume. We don't have equipment for aspirating such tiny volume, so we can scale it to a microliter by multiplying by 1,000 to get 6.66 microliters. So if we were to take 6.66 microliters accurately, then from that 3 million per mil cell suspension, we will have our 20,000 cells that we want. In reality, though, pipetting 6.66 microliters of cells will be subject to inaccuracies because microliter volumes with cells are not as accurate. So I would recommend that you actually do a 1 in 10 initial dilution. So you would take 66.6 microliters, dilute it 1 in 10 with media, and then take that another 66.6 microliters of that in order to get your more accurate pipetting process. With that out of the way, let's look at how we get a certain concentration of cells. Cell passaging and seeding. And in order to do this, we need to calculate the number of cells needed to seed a new culture dish or flask based on desired confluency or cell density. So let's just stick to the same number, but this time we want 20,000 cells per mil. How do you get that? For this, you'd need to dilute the current cell suspension to get the 20,000 cells per mil. So you need to know the dilution factor. So in such instances where you want the concentration, you have to dilute the concentration you have by the concentration you want. We have a concentration of 3 by 10 to the 6th per mil cells, 3 million cells. So we're going to divide that by 20,000 cells per mil that we want. And we see that we get a dilution factor of 1 in 150. So this would mean that the 3 million cells per mil suspension would need to be scaled up or diluted to 150 mil in order to have each mil contain 20,000 cells. Alternatively, whatever fraction of the cells we take, we need to scale it up 150 times in order to achieve that dilution factor. So say I wanted to take just 150 microliters, then I would dilute that in 22.5 mils in order to have that ratio maintained. Let's do some practice runs to get you ready for the lab. You count cells and the cell counter reports 4 by 10 to the 6 cells, so 4 million cells per mil. Your culture vessel is in a total volume of 5 mil. So the cells have been cultured in a total volume of 5 mil, and each mil of that is 4 million cells. How many cells do you have in total? So this one wants you to calculate total number of cells. Since we have 4 million cells in a mil, and we have a total volume of 5 mil, we simply multiply the 4 million cells per mil by the 5 mil total volume that we have. And that gives us 2 by 10 to the 7 cells, or 20 million cells. So let's do a second one. What volume should you take if you want to subculture 1 by 10 to the 5 cells? So you want 100,000 cells. Since we know that we have 20 million cells, or 2 by 10 to the 7 cells in total, to get our 100,000 cells, or 1 by 10 to the 5 cells, we divide 1 by 10 to the 5 cells by the 2 by 10 to the 7 cells. This reports a volume of 0.005 milliliters, which is, again, quite a tiny volume for us to pipette. We scale it to microliters, so you can use your pipette and set it to 5 microliters in order to do it. But keep in mind, in reality, 5 microliters of cells will be riddled with inaccuracy, so you can once again scale everything, say, 10 times, and then dilute 1 in 10, and you'll be able to take 50 microliters instead. You would then pop the cells with media and let the cells grow in a CO2 incubator. The CO2 percentage is usually 5%. A final example, how would you make a cell suspension of 3 by 10 to the 5 cells per mil? 3 by 10 to the 5 cells per mil. So this one is a concentration question. In each milliliter that we take, we want to have 3 by 10 to the 5 cells. 300,000 cells. As a reminder, with concentration questions such as these, you are looking at dilution factors or a ratio. So we want 300,000 cells per mil, and we have 4 million cells per mil. The calculation, therefore, will be the 4 million cells per mil. We're going to divide that by the 300,000 cells that we want. And we get a dilution factor or a ratio of 1 in 13.33. So this means that we would literally take 1 mil and divide it by 13.33, 1 mil of the 4 million cell suspension divided by 13.33, and whatever the answer is would be the volume that we take that would and make up in order to get our 300,000 cells. You would then top up the media your volume that you require. So making up complete media for your cell culture is a critical technique that you will need. Please take a look at the video that discusses this technique. I've linked it in the comments. So in closing, these calculations require you to be very clear on what you want. Foundational to all the calculations is knowing what you are starting off with. Do you know what your current concentration is? What about your current volume? Finally, what is your total cell numbers? Next, once you have these foundational information, next you need to be clear on what you are calculating. Do you want an amount or a concentration? Please confirm your understanding of the difference between an amount and a concentration in the comments. Lastly, don't give up if you find it difficult to do this calculation at first. I too used to struggle with these, and I've met many a postdoc and senior scientist who still struggle with these. Just keep practicing, and all the best with your experiments.